Hi guys, welcome. So I am back, slowly coming back, but I am back, and I'm really excited to share this video with you. I've been working on it for the past week now, and I am just really excited to be back, and I'm really excited to explain to you guys, well, not excited, but I guess I'm happy that I can now like talk to you guys about why I was gone without sobbing like a baby, and just really happy that I get to talk to you guys again. So the next few videos you're gonna see are just me explaining and then talking about CMTC, and then we'll get on with the video. So enjoy. So number one, I want to talk about why I've been gone. So there's a reason why I just took the whole month and like didn't post a video and I pushed the video, and then there's why videos are coming out so slow. So why videos are coming out so slow is like the least important part. But I just want to tell you guys, like, I am still learning how to edit. I'm only editing on my phone right now, so it's kind of hard for me. But soon I'm hoping to get a better, a better product to use to edit on. And I'm shopping for something right now, and I'm also still learning. I have a few different tutorials I've been watching, and I've been using LinkedIn Learning a lot, so I am still learning, but I'm getting there. And then the reason why I just pushed this video so long is the most important one. And I had some unfortunate news when I came home, and it was that my cat Boxer had passed away while I was gone. And it was a really hard thing to wrap my head around because he's been my cat for 12 years. I was a little girl when he was first born. And I picked him at a litter as, you know, my cat. I was gonna take care of him. And I did. I took care of him as much as I could. I loved him as much as I could. And it's really hard when you lose a pet. It's really hard when you lose anybody. But losing pets has been something I've had to go through multiple times in my life compared to losing people. So it's a hard thing. And that's also a hard thing for me. So I've just been trying to take care of myself mentally and physically, and I just kept pushing the video because I didn't want to have to talk about it, and I just didn't want to have to like get up and do it. But I'm still, you know, grieving. You're always grieving, but I think I'm getting better at it now, and I think I'm slowly picking myself up and starting to roll with the punches again and starting to go through life. So yeah, that's why I push so hard, and I hope you guys can understand. I think you guys will understand, and I hope that you're not mad at me, but I promise I am going to start making schedules for the videos too, and what I want to post and all that stuff, because this is something I pride myself on, and I love editing and making stuff like this. So I am back, but the videos are still going to be slow as I'm still learning. So now I want to talk about CMTC, what I did there, you know, what happened, what you're gonna see in the videos. So a lot of the videos are the road trip up and then things I did there. Like I did like my day recap for 2 days, I think, and then I posted videos of like the mall we got to go to, and then decided to show all the pictures and videos I took while I was there. I just started the YouTube channel about a month before I left, so it was kind of hard for me to be like, oh shoot, you know, like what do? How do I get somebody else to record me while I'm in the lineups and doing stuff like that? I also didn't know the rules. And when I got there, I found out that if you're over a certain age limit, you know, your parent or person can't be in line with you. So that would have been hard for me to, you know, record. But next year I want to plan to record more if I go back and be more prepared. But me and my mom went together, and she got really sick from the drive up our first 2 days, so it was really hard for me to also get her to like hold the phone for me and vlog because she was sick. So I did a lot of it myself, which was fine, you know, I should be doing it all by myself, but I would have liked to get videos of like me and my friends in the lineup and, you know, coming in and out of auditions and different things like that. And I also didn't want to hurt anybody's feelings if I took videos of them without permission. So it was a lot of me just, you know, learning how to be a YouTuber in a big convention like that. But I still had a lot of fun. I loved all the competitions. I loved meeting all the Asians. I loved meeting new people. I have new friends now that I still talk to. and the dances were fun, and I feel like I really got out of my comfort zone. And that's something that I promised I wanted to show with this YouTube channel, is getting out of your comfort zone. So I really just want to harp on that. I wasn't going to do this. I got really scared. I was panicking the whole time I had to do things. But at the end of it, I had a lot of fun. I left the dances being like, oh, I actually stayed like majority of the time. And I didn't think I was going to. I was like, oh, I'm going to stay for like 30 minutes, an hour tops. Like, I'm just going to show up, show my face, leave. And I had a lot of fun. And I made friends with people. Everyone was very kind. And even if there's somebody alone, a lot of us took to those people and made sure that they had fun. And it was nice knowing I was one of those people that were helping other people get out of their shells. And I talked to a lot of people. I'm not a talker when it comes to like strangers, but people just came up to you there and complimented you, and you would start a conversation with them. And either some things I said or like something I've done that, you know, I'm gonna cringe at for the rest of my life or be embarrassed at, but I learned from them and I won't do it again. You know what I mean? And just, you know, everybody was so nice. If you sat beside someone you didn't know, you would talk to them. And it was really cool knowing that I left with a lot of connections, and maybe I don't see those people again, but I talked to them and it got me one step closer to my goal of getting out of my comfort zone completely. And it was just, it was a proud moment. Like, even though I came home to some sad stuff, I still feel proud. And I felt proud in the moment there. And it was really nice. And I felt like I've accomplished something. And meeting the agents, you'd think like, oh, these are big time agents, like they're gonna be like mean. No, they are so cool and down to earth and nice. Like, they don't care. They're just like you. Like, they don't think like, oh, I work out of New York or Los Angeles, I'm better than these people. They think, no, I'm gonna help you work out of these places. I'm gonna help you become the person you wanna be. And their seminars were so entertaining and so full of knowledge. Like, they made everything seem fun. Like, a lot of the agents just came up on that stage and they knew, like, they have to grab your attention, and they fully grabbed our attention. And it was really cool to like be in a room with such powerful people and learning. I took a lot of notes. I voice recorded a lot of different things and took pictures with them, and I think I came home with a lot more knowledge of the industry than I ever have before, and that was nice. It was really nice to know that I now, like, it's nice to feel comfortable, if that makes sense, and now I feel comfortable with the industry that I've picked to want to be in, and it's not as bad as everyone makes it seem. It's not as closed in as people make it seem. It is growing rapidly. This industry of acting and modeling and singing and dancing is growing so fast and in a way that matches everybody's needs, if that makes sense. So it was a good time. It was definitely a good experience, and it was something I can cross off my bucket list now, which is a very nice thing to do. Okay, so quickly, I just want to touch on like my day-to-day. So like what I did and how I did it, how it looked. So every morning I got up around 6 a.m, no matter if my start was 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. Quickly, if you're wondering what's in my hand, it's my shutter button. So I don't have to like lean up and turn the thing off. I can just click, click. Anyway, so if it was like a later start, if it was like a 9 a.m. start some days, I would maybe watch TV till about like 6:30, but then I'd get up and shower and do my hair and my makeup. And I'm not really good at my hair, nor am I good at makeup. Like, I'm still learning. But when I tell you my hair looked good all weekend, it looked so good all weekend. Like, I don't know why I was gifted with wavy, semi-curly hair and, like, long hair because it grows so fast, because I don't know what to do with it. Like, right now my hair looks ratchet because I've only been up for about, like, 2 hours today and I still have to work out and, like, shower. So I haven't done my hair. You know what I mean? I'm not that good at that stuff. But I don't know what happened in CMTC. It's like a power came out of me that I never knew I had. And I did my hair all weekend long. And same my makeup. My makeup looked okay, I'll say. But What else did I do in the mornings? I ate too. Like, I would eat, like, sometimes I'd have coffee. Like, I'd go down to the cafe and get me and my mom a coffee, or I would, like, just drink a shit ton of water. But honestly, I didn't eat that much. Like, I was so nauseous from just, like, the nerves and all the feelings I was having and all the commotion that I ate, like, half a muffin or half an apple or, like, a bite of a sandwich and some chips that I had in the fridge. Like, that's just all I kind of could eat. I would feel full all day long, though. I would drink water all day long. Like, all day I'd carry my water bottle with me, but it was never, like, I need food. Like, unless it was nighttime, I'd eat. Like, one day me and my mom went to the buffet, and, like, I ate, like, two cinnamon rolls and, like, a banana and a yogurt, I think, and that was, like, the most I'd eaten the whole weekend. And it wasn't, like, bad. I wasn't starving myself, because at night I would eat, like, from the restaurant, like chicken strips or a burger or a wrap. But it was like during the day I just couldn't eat a lot, and I feel like a lot of people felt that way too, just because we were so nervous and so giddy and excited. But I still, like, you know, stayed hydrated, so I didn't, like, faint in the middle of the freaking competition. And then after I would eat, I would probably just chill for a little bit. I'd call Talia. Me and her would call, like, every morning, every night, and I'd talk to my friends, and then it'd be time to go. So we'd go and we'd get in our lineups. If it was a seminar, we'd go into the seminar, listen to about three or four, and then go to a competition. But if it was a competition, right in the morning, we'd go right to lineup. And then we would do the competition, come back out. We had breaks in between. Like, a lot of days, it was like 2 to 3 hour breaks in between, but then one day, because I didn't do runway this year, which I regret, and I'm gonna do it next year. But there was a 5 hour, I think it was 4.5 hours maybe. I don't know, it was 4-5-ish hour, like, break in between where everybody was at runway. So, like, if you were at runway, you had all that time. So I used that time to go to the mall. Me and my mom, the first night, because first night was check-in, and then you're just done for the rest of the day. You only had, like, 20 minutes to check-in, and then you could do what you want. We went to a little mall that was, like, 5-10 minutes down the road. But then this, like, the third day when we had the, like, break, we went to, I don't remember what it was called, like C, like Central Mall or something like that. One of, like, the bigger malls in the city. We went, and oh my God, I had never seen, I didn't know Walmart could be 3 stories, okay? Let's just say that. All the stores were 2 to 3 stories. I had never been in a Nike store before, and I went and bought my first Nike hoodie. There was an all black owned store that I went in. Like, I bought myself a new bonnet, and then I bought a do-rag for me and Celia to share when we get our braids in, because she usually gets hers in a different time than I get mine in. So I bought, like, a velvet green one, and what else did I buy? I bought so much. Like, I should not have spent so much money there, but I couldn't help it. There was an indigenous store, but it was closed, and I really wanted to go get a new pair of, like, beaded earrings or, like, a beaded bracelet, but it was closed, so that was sad. We couldn't find, like, the food courts. We ended up eating at McDonald's, which was kind of sad, but it is what it is. There were so many nice things. Like, that mall was beautiful, and I should have taken a video of the little, like mini, like, I don't know what it was called, but it was, like, a bunch of bakeries and, like, really different, like, weird, like, not weird, but, like, different aesthetics going on of, like, different restaurants. And we couldn't find anything that wasn't, like, pork or, like, donuts. Like, there was a lot of sweet shops or pork shops. Like, there was nothing in between, if that makes sense. There was, like, just so much happening. Or sushi. We couldn't find, like, any, like, regular places. My mom just wanted, like, a sandwich or, like, a burger, and I just wanted, like, anything at that point. Like, I don't know, it was just a whole ordeal, but it was really exciting. And then the night we had the award show, it was, like, a bittersweet moment, because it was, like, our final hurrah of the night. We were gonna go dance and sing and have fun, and then it was, like, the next day we leave, we're all gonna say goodbye. So I got to hug and cry and, you know, say I was gonna miss everyone, and it was really fun. And like I said, me and my mom had met 2 people there that we hung out with the whole time, so it was nice to have Brooke and her mom with me and my mom too, because then, like, my mom had someone to talk to and it wasn't just me. But it was cool. It was a surreal moment, the award show, and then that final dance, because everybody knew it was our last night, and we were like just having fun and like, oh, hope to see you next year's. And they really felt meant, like, meaningful. Like, when people would say, like, I hope to see you next year, and when I'd say it to people, it was like, we really meant that. Like, I really hope to see you next year. Or, like, I hope to see you on a billboard someday. Like, we really just wanted everyone to have their moment, and we all wanted every one of us to do it together. And it was really nice. And then the next morning, we went swimming with Brooke and her mom, which was really fun. Even though we barely got swimming because there was a giant spider in the pool and we couldn't get it out, so we like stayed on the other side. But we just all had got to talk and have a good time, and then we went to pack and say goodbye, and just, it was really weird. It was a weird moment of walking out of there. Like, we went to pay for our room, and then we took all of our stuff and we said goodbye, and then leaving, it was like, take me back. Like, I still, me and my mom would randomly just like think about it and be like, oh, let's go back. And the drive home was a lot slower than the drive up. But the drive home, I, you know, got the news. And it was weird knowing I was coming home to everybody. Because my mom didn't want me to just come home and everybody be like, oh, we're so sorry. Like, you know, hugging me and everything. Because I didn't know what was going on. So then eventually I got told, and we were about 3 hours away from home, so that I wouldn't come home so shocked. But it was just like, the drive home was really, like, it dragged on. But the drive up was really fun. It was just, like, a surreal experience for me and my mom. Just me and her. Like, music at, like, 5%. Just talking all night long. And, like, stopping at these different gas stations and stopping in places we've never been before. And, like, it was just really cool. And we stayed in Quebec City on the way home, which was really nice. Like, in the middle of Quebec City, we stayed at a little hotel, and that was cool, too. Just seeing, like, they have, like, orangish yellow lights for their streetlights, and it made everything feel like a movie. Just the way the lights were, like, pouring down into the street, and everything looked orange and, like, peaceful at night. But I can't imagine living in a big city like that, where the highways are, like, their city streets, and they're, like, six-lane highways. I can't imagine. I'd be, like, crying every time I had to go on. I was pretty much, like, having a heart attack every time we had to drive somewhere. But it was a really nice and fun weekend. And I hope to go again next year. And maybe next year, me and my mom haven't decided if we're going to fly or drive again. We could probably do it again. But, like, and we don't know if we're going to be, if I'm, like, me and my mom are going to go together. Or if I'm going to bring Talia this time instead. But it was really fun, and I enjoyed it. And even though things didn't go as 100% planned, that's life, and I have to take it with a grain of salt. But now I give you the vlog, and I hope you enjoy. And yeah, thanks for sticking around and listening to me go on a tangent about everything that I did.
Hey! We are driving for past hour and a half now, right? I want to say almost to Edmonton?
Not almost, but close.
Yeah, close.
It's my mom. We're very excited. We have 12 more hours to go.
It's so fun.
Actually, we are going to have a lot of fun.
I'm only going to update y'all like every like, oh, I don't like this truck. We're going to have to go back.
Just calm down.
You're not driving.
Exactly.
I'm gonna update y'all every like few hours, maybe. I'm not gonna update like every like hour on the hour, just because that's ridiculous. But I'm probably gonna update you if the next like stop we go to, and then yeah, we'll see from there. So I'll see you soon.
Oh my god, it looks so bad because it's nighttime.
Anyway, it's 8:52 for where us. For where us? It's 9:51. In St. John right now, but here in Quebec it's 8:52. We still have 8 hours to go. It's actually really funny how exhausted I am, but how hyper I am at the same time. I guarantee mom's not doing so good either. How you doing, mom?
I'm good.
That's a surprise. Yeah, so we're like in Quebec but not in Quebec at the same time. I don't really know how to explain it. Mom keeps saying like we're in Quebec but we're not, so it's like But when you look at our Find My iPhone, it says we're in Quebec City, so I'm just gonna say we're there. We're gonna try to make it to Montreal before we decide if we're going to sleep or keep driving. So I'll update you.
Okay, we're at our second gas station of the night, and we really want to try to find a hotel to stay at because it's 1 a.m. and we're done driving.
It's 2 a.m.
Yeah, where we're from. Not here.
Yeah, it's pretty fucking close to 2 a.m.
Anyway, we're tired, sweaty, done driving. All right, I forgot to vlog last night, but we're here in Toronto, in the hotel room. Fucking gorgeous in here. Very nice bellboy. They give us complimentary water. Yeah, very nice bellboy. Is that what you call them nowadays?
I don't know.
Assistant, we'll say. He helped us carry.
We might put down and get our food.
All of our stuff. On one of those like fancy gold things. We have wipes. The TV says good afternoon, Andrea.
Oh.
Ooh. Okay, what does this TV have though? That's the question.
Just be careful, don't be doing anything that
Okay, so we have an ice tray bucket, which I will be going to grab ice. I'm just trying to see if they have a channel list. In here. There's no channel list. Unless it's over here. Oh, nope. They have 2 Bibles. Period. That's the first hotel in a long time we've had Bibles at. Anyway, we're very tired. It's been a long, long few days for us. So we are going to take a nap and possibly eat before I have to go check in. So peace. All right, guys, we went to the mall because my check-in took... No, for vlog. It took 2 seconds to sign in, so we have all night. I went to the Lego store and got me and Mom into custom Lego people. We got to build them. Well, today I got to do it over FaceTime. But I'm going to kind of vlog every place that I haven't been in before. We're going to go to Everest Jewels. I'm so excited. We just go back to the hotel. I am goddamn exhausted. I got these, I don't know, they're acupressure ear cuffs. They improve digestion, reduce water retention, boost metabolism, relieve stress, balance hormones. We're gonna try them, because why not? And then I got some tea.
Shiny?
Yeah. Why? Okay, I got this tea because it's low caffeine, but it's to help get an energized burst without the crash that caffeine gives you, so I'm hoping that works. I also got me and Talia and my mom custom, where are they?
Oh, I got no water.
Lego pieces. I'm so excited. They were super, super cute. Anyway, I'm gonna get undressed and talk to you later. Okay, hi. Long time no see.
Wow.
I don't think I vlogged when I even got to the hotel. It's been a long 2 days, and the day is already almost started. It's 8:36. I have to go downstairs for a seminar in like 20 minutes. Not feeling it today. I stupidly stayed up until about 1 a.m. yesterday because I went to the dance, and then I went to play cards against humanity, and now I'm here. I kind of just woke up this morning and was like, I don't want to exist today. But I've been watching planes come in and out in the mornings and at night. Move, chair. Y'all see this shit? I hear one. I'm gonna get a plane on camera for you guys. Oh, don't look at me close up. My skin's horrible right now. I've been wearing makeup for 8 hours straight every day. Anywho, I did 4 seminars yesterday, a workshop, and a competition. Today I have 3 seminars. 1 conversation and then a dance. So I'm excited. Oh, you see that? You see?
Coming or going?
Going. Nice. Anyway, so that's the plan. I'm not excited, but I'm nervous. Tonight's a fashion crimes dance, so I'll show y'all my outfit because I'm gonna look really funny. And then tomorrow is a big day. I have improv early in the morning and then I have my photography go see. And then it's the celebration, the award show celebration dance. Then Sunday is callback day. Sunday is the biggest day of the week. I get to find out if the agents liked me, if they believe in me, and I get to go talk to them. So, I'll record more when I can. I should bring my tripod, but I'm stupid, so I've been using my arm for everything, so it hurts. Goodbye.
Last day. So it's the last day. It's callback day. I got two. So I'm all dressed up, ready to go. Gonna leave in like 5 minutes probably. And then we hit the road today to go home. So I was really busy this weekend, so I didn't have a lot of time to record. I did like one or two recaps with you guys. So I think when I go home, I'm gonna do a bigger recap and like edit some photos and pictures that I took while I'm here and just, you know, relive the moment with you guys. I can't wait to sleep. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got. Let me show it. You are exactly what I want. Kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself 2 callbacks. Let's go.
Guys, it's Hayden now editing. Same person you just saw at the beginning of the video. I just wanted to say hi. Thank you so much for watching. Because I didn't know if I should just leave the slideshow like abruptly and stop, or if I should like say something. Then I remembered I have to tell you guys to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Do it, because a lot of more videos are coming. I'm learning, and they're coming. Oh, don't. Thank you. So, if you enjoyed, like, comment, subscribe. I don't really care if you share, but do all the other 3 things, and you'll get a cookie. You won't get a cookie. I mean, you can get an emoji one if you want. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your days, afternoons, evenings, nights, wherever you are. I love you all, and I'll see you soon. Bye, fuckers.